What's good, LHS? I'm Anthony.
And I'm Emily. Welcome back to another episode of The Announcements.
Let's start with our new traffic rules at LHS.
If you haven't already, take some time to review Dr. Nordo's post on Schoology about the morning change in traffic patterns.
Help make morning drop-off a safe and efficient experience.
That was a nice and informative video. I hope you pay attention.
Let's hear about our sports.
This Thursday, our football team will be playing Cedar Crest in our annual Cedar Bowl. It's our last regular season game, and we love to pack Cedar Crest Stadium with our fans.
School rivalries, sometimes wild, sometimes funny, sometimes pretty intense. They've been a part of American school culture forever. Our annual showdown with Cedar Crest in the Cedar Bowl is a great opportunity to support our school against one of our rivals. It had us wondering how this rivalry measures up to other regional clashes. So we set out to find out about our teachers' own experiences with high school rivalries.
So yeah, rivalries so important in high school sports, college sports, professional sports. I went to Lancaster Catholic. Our biggest rivalry was McCaskey.
I played basketball, football, and tennis. School rivalry was always Cedar Crest. We also had a pretty good basketball rivalry with Hempfield.
Played basketball, softball, and volleyball. When my grandparents went to school, it was Cedar Crest, but our rivalry when I played was Loving Catholic.
History of the rivalry goes back since Cedar Crest became a school, just because of how close our schools are. But
during football, they would sneak into our school and they would put fishes on the radiators because it was always the last game of the season, so the heat was on and it would smell like fish.
Had a marine session before the game that we played Loving Catholic, so we actually took some of their stuff, which was all premeditated, and had a bonfire.
It was kids that you grew up with, just like it is now. You guys grew up with those Cedar Crest kids. I played baseball with a lot of the Cedar Crest kids that were on that team. But just going out there, even though they might have beat us in football, we always had kind of the last laugh because we got to beat them in basketball, and we always beat them pretty good.
All right, real talk though, I love it because it's a rivalry game. It's always packed out. It's the best game of the year.
See you there. And on to esports with Max.
If you haven't noticed the post on Schoology, our esports team has also been on a roll. Our esports team competes in two games, Rocket League, which is 2-1, and Super Smash Bros., which is 3-0. Our Rocket League's only loss came from a two-time defending state champion. Keep it up, guys.
It seems like the esports team is having a great year.
Make sure to go cheer on for the football team so they have a great game.
Let's check out the Powder Puff feature with Lillian Knight.
Have you signed up for the Powder Puff game on November 2nd?
What's Powder Puff?
It's a game where the roles are reversed and girls are on the field playing football or flag ball while the guys are the cheerleaders. But why is it called Powder Puff?
Well, it's called Powder Puff because of the tool women use to apply makeup.
When did it start?
Well, potentially in the 1930s.
When it was first publicized, it happened in 1945 due to the lack of male football players due to World War II at East State Teachers College.
Therefore, feel free to join us as we carry on a tradition on November 2nd.
How interesting. I never knew the history of Powder Puff.
It seems like a lot of fun. Speaking of fun, let's check out the Super Surveys with Brayden and Tristan.
This is Super Surveys and you're asking, what's your favorite superpower?
I think my favorite superpower is, or would be, it's tough, you know, because there's a lot of cool ones out there. It would be mind reading. To be able to read someone's mind, I think that'd be the coolest one.
Alright, so the superpower that I would want is teleportation, so that I can travel wherever I want, whenever I want.
I would want to fly so I can get places faster and be able to see over everything.
I want to have the ability to slow down time so I could do everything while everybody can do nothing.
I would like super speed because I would have every record ever and just be unstoppable.
This was Super Surveys. Looks like this week's answers were pretty random. come to 201 or have your teacher email any requests. See you next time.
Thanks, guys. We should do more of these.
I agree, Emily. But now it's time for the girls' wrestling high nights with Carmia.
Wrestling is one of the fastest girls' growing sports in the country. Our girls' only practices will be about having fun and learning the sport of wrestling. They are open to female students enrolled in Lebanon School District. You should come out, try out. Make sure to wear shorts, a t-shirt, no buttons, zippers, or jewelry of any kind, and bring a water bottle.
I hope you go out and try out wrestling. You can find that you actually enjoy it.
Let's check out today's trivia with Peyton.
Congratulations to no one for winning last week's trivia. Here's last week's featured teachers. This week, we're switching things up, spooky style. Pay attention to the different sounds associated with different scary movies and shows. Identify the show or movie it is from. Do you have your answer? If so, discuss it with your seminar and have your teacher send Ms. Rodriguez an email. Good luck.
Good luck. Good luck.
Yeah. Can't wait for the answers.
Thanks for watching the weekly announcements.
See you soon.